बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। द टॉपिक विच वी कवर इन दिस लेक्चर इज़ द ऑर्गेनोलैप्टिक इवेल्युएशन ऑफ द क्रूड ड्रग। एज वी ऑल नो दैट वी वर कैरिंग आउट द ऑर्गेनोलैप्टिक इवेल्युएशन ऑफ द फूड ड्रग्स इन आवर प्रीवियस लैब, बट इन दिस लेक्चर बिफोर प्रोसीडिंग टू द न्यू ड्रग्स आई वुड लाइक टू रिवाइज सम बेसिक टर्मिनोलॉजीज लाइक क्रूड ड्रग डेफिनेशन and its various type, what is the evaluation, what is the organoleptic evaluation, and after that revision we will start our next fruit drug. So first of all, what is crude drug, how can we define it? As you know that crude drugs are vegetable or animal drugs that consist of natural substances that have undergone the process of collection and drying only. You all know that natural drugs may be come from plant kingdom, animal kingdom, marine, microbes and mineral source. Here in this our lab, we are just performing the evaluation of the drugs coming from the plant kingdom. Now, coming to its various types. So, here is it. The official, unofficial and non-official crude drug. These basically classification is based on the entry of the crude drug in the official pharmacopoeia or herbal pharmacopoeia. The first one is the official drug. Any drug included in the current issue of the pharmacopoeia of a country and officially used for therapeutic purpose is known as official drug. On the other hand, the drug is said to be unofficial when it was previously included in the issue, any issue of the pharmacopoeia, but not present in the current issue or any drug literature. While the non-official crude drugs are those crude drugs that have some medicinal properties and they are used for many therapeutic purposes, but these drugs are never been included in any of the pharmacopoeia or drug literature of any country. These are called non-official drugs. Now, coming to the classification which is based on the morphological part of the drug may be divided into organized and unorganized. Organized drugs are those crude drugs that are basically the morphological part or anatomical part of the plant. That is, they may be roots, shoot, bark, seed, fruit, legume, leaf, flower, etc. These drugs are directly obtained from the plant. In our labs of the third semester, as I told you before, that we will cover only the organized drug. Organized drugs have basic cellular structure, that is, they have stomata, coccyx, trichomes, vascular bundle, different kind of cells. So they can be identified using microscope by performing the histological section cutting and the powder microscope. They all are solid in nature. While on the other hand, coming toward the unorganized drug, so unorganized drugs are those crude drugs that are basically the primary or secondary metabolite of the plant. These are not the morphological parts. Example include extracts, exudates, many secondary metabolites like alkaloid, glycosides, fixed oil, volatile oils, etc. But the point to remember is that these are not the morphological part of the plant. These are not directly obtained from the plant. These are basically, if you want to obtain it, we have to adopt some physical, mechanical or chemical procedure for it. Sometime it may be extraction using expression, distillation, using soft clay apparatus, distillation assembly. The point is we have to obtain it from some mechanical, physical means. They don't have any cellular structure like stomata, coccyx cell, epidermal cells, trichomes, etc. They don't have any. These crude drugs may be solid, these may be liquid, these may be semi-solid in nature, and basically these are identified by means of chemical test, microchemistry or chromatography, etc. Now here our revision is completed, and now we will proceed for our organoleptic evaluation. Before this, we just thoroughly quickly pass through the definition of the evaluation. Evaluation of the drug means confirmation of its identity, determination of its quality and purity, and detection of nature of adulteration. I will make a complete detailed slide of evaluation and will upload for you people so that you may understand it fully. Now, organoleptic evaluation is a type of evaluation which you are now performing. You already know this. Organoleptic means the evaluation of the crude drug using organ of senses. It includes the detection of color, odor, taste, sound, and its morphological feature like texture, size, external and internal marking, etc. These are also known as morphological or macroscopic evaluation. Point to remember is that these are the macroscopic evaluation. You don't need any microscope for it. Only your organ of senses will be used to identify any drug. Now, from here our proper lecture is started. We were basically performing the food drug or fructic drugs. We have covered 6 drugs in this regard in our proper lab. Now I will just provide you the pictures and the pharmacognostic feature of the drug and the organoleptic evaluation of the drug. With the help of the picture uploaded, you can understand what I am saying. You may ask me any question if you are unable to understand it. I will brief you about the Reithia tinctoria, embalic officinalis and Pongamia glabra in these slides. First of all, coming toward the Reithia tinctoria. This is a picture of the Reithia tinctoria, okay? And this is the basically fresh flower. And you may see it fruit. It is a dried form which you have present in your lab. Okay. Now, first of all, let's talk about its introduction. Like, its English name is sweet Indarju. Its local name is Indarju. Its family is belong to the family Apocynaceae. And we are using fruit, bark and leaf of the drug. I already told you that each morphological part of the plant has different phytochemical constituent in it. Okay? I hope you remember this. So here we are observing the fruit of the drug. First of all, as we used to do in our class, normal labs, we discuss the pharmacognostic feature of the drug, that is its phytochemical constituent. It contains different kind of carbohydrates, fixed oil 30%, beta C2-esterol, and some important secondary metabolite also like alkaloid. The main important alkaloid which we obtain from it is retinal. Retinal is the active ingredient, medicinal agent obtained from the Reithia tinctoria, responsible for many activities. Apart from retinol, we have cycloacetinone, beta-imidin. Coming toward the medicinal action and uses, the drug is used as an histamatic. You all know histamatic is the drug that is used to improve the function of the stomach. Antipyretic means drug that are used to reduce the fever, body temperature. Anti-inflammatory drugs that are using against inflammation. It is also used as a tonic because it we have seen in our previous slide that is have many carbohydrates, fixed oil, etc. And beta acetoesterol, plant cholesterol is actually beta acetoesterol. So it is also used as a tonic. Also used in pain, toothache, diseases caused by the ringworms, especially skin diseases, piles, diarrhea. Okay, that was the introduction of the drug. Now coming toward the organoleptic evaluation. Definitely you are not have the original sample, but you may understand it by looking at this picture. You may zoom it, and I will try to let you understand whatever I want to. Coming toward the texture, it is rough. External marking, it contains the pseudo wrinkles. Then a notch is present at the apex, and base is also pointed and slightly depressed from the center. If you can see that depression or clear depression is seen. Bifurcate the seat into two parts, you can see it. The base is pointed, apex is also pointed. Internal marking after we break it, a brown compact mass is present. Fracture is complete with a snap. Color is dull brown. It is odorless. Its taste is sweet, so that's why it is known as sweet inderjoo. Its shape is linear and its size is almost 1.3 centimeter. Now come toward the second drug, that is Embelica officinalis. Amla. English name is Embelica fruit or Indian gooseberry. Local name is Amla. Family is Euphorbiaceae. And the parts which I have used is our fruits, roots and seeds. You can see the difference in the fresh and the fresh form of the fruit, that is this one. And the crude drug, when it has been converted into the crude drug after drying, collection and drying. This is also, these are the same thing. You can see its morphology when it was in fresh form, and after being dried, it has been changed shape. Okay. Pharmacognostic feature, phytochemical constituent, it contains alkaloid, then vitamin C, which is also known as ascorbic acid. Rich amount of vitamin C is present. We all know that Embelica has a very sour taste, and it is used in pickles in our daily routine. We can use it as a edible item. It also contains tartaric acid. Both of these constituents, that is vitamin C and tartaric acid, make its taste so sour taste. See? Then flavonoids, polyphenols, a number of tannins, that is oligotannins, embelicalin A, embelicalin B, gallic acid, egallic acid. All of these constituents are present in Amla. Now, medicinal action uses, it prevent hair loss. We all know that Amla has been incorporated in number of shampoos and oils to, you know, strengthen the hair growth. Despite of the hair growth, it is also used to help in the bowel movement. It cleans colon, and its bitter and sour taste actually stimulate the taste bud. It is used as an expectorant, एंटीऑक्सीडेंट ड्यू टू द प्रेजेंस ऑफ द फिनोल्स एंड पॉलीफिनोल्स एंड फ्लेवोनॉइड दीज टू कंपाउंड इट एग्जिबिट एंटीऑक्सीडेंट एक्टिविटी. दैट इज एंटीऑक्सीडेंट मीन्स द ड्रग विच यूज टू डिस्ट्रॉय द पेरोक्साइड दैट हैज बीन फॉर्म्ड इन अवर बॉडी. It used to. It is. The peroxide are actually responsible for a number of diseases: diabetes mellitus, cancer, and so many diseases. So these drugs actually destroy the oxides. Okay. One important thing that it is increases the high density lipoprotein level and simultaneously decrease the low density lipoprotein levels. It's also vitamin C. So it prevent what it is also used in scurvy. And the glycosylated product that has been formed in the body can be prevented by using Imbalica officinalis fruit. Organoleptic evaluation. Structure is the rough. External marking a multi-wrinkled notch at the apex. Base rounded, a sticky one. Internal marking, brown mass. Fracture is complete with sound. Color is dull brown. Odor is odorless. Taste sweet and sour. Sweet and sour. And shape is linear to crescent, and size is 1.3 centimeter. Now come to the third drug, Pongamia glabra. Karanja. Its English name is Indian beech. Local name is Karanja. Family Papilionaceae. Part used fruit, roots, seeds, and flowers. Pharmacognostic features. Phytochemical constituent in the alkaloid, glabrosaponin, glabrin, kanjon, carangin, pongamol. Pongapin, quercetin, saponin, beta-sitosterols, tannins, and protein, starch, fixed oil, resin, sugar. As you can see at the phytochemical constituent, this is basically a number of secondary metabolite medicinally present in Pongamia glabra. It is not used as an edible item in our daily routine. It is basically a herb used for the therapeutic purposes. Now coming towards its medicinal action and uses. Oil of the Pongamia glabra is used in various skin diseases. So is herpes, scabies, eczema, leucoderma, psoriasis, antiseptic, as a pesticide, as an antibacterial agent, and joint pain. When you perform this organoleptic evaluation, you can see the texture is smooth. Okay, texture is smooth. External marking, black petiole is present, and scar, black scar, you can see it, is present at top. Surface is shiny, smooth, and base is rounded. Internal marking, when you gonna break it, it can you, what you can see a white seed present in it. This one also. Fracture is hard, tough rather. Color is gray. Odor sweet. Taste bitter. Shape is spherical. And size is almost 1.5 centimeter. So that's all for the first lecture, and we will continue inshallah in our future slides.